of Punjab. First of all, introductions. Agriculture sector contributes 70.4% of the Indian gross domestic product in 2015 and 16, as compared to the 18.3% in 2013 and 14. Agriculture sector plays a vital role in employment generation in Indian economy, with nearly half of the Indian population being dependent on the agriculture and allied activities for livelihood. About 49% of the total workforce is still engaged in farming and allied sectors activities. Due to the green revolution, subsistence agriculture move on to the modern and commercial agriculture. The expenditure on modern input has been steadily growing because new technology requires huge amount of investment, which can be only afforded by the large farmers. So most of the small farmers and marginal farmers cannot afford heavy investment out of their own funds. The benefit of the new agriculture technology in agriculture are mainly restricted to the farmers with large holding, and these with smaller holding still continues to have traditional method of cultivation because they are unable to make heavy investment. Increase in population has caused more subdivision of land holdings, which has further increased the number of marginal and small farmers. Next. Since mid-1980s, suicide by cultivators and agriculture laborers have reported in Punjab. A recent statewide survey conducted by economics departments of various universities of Punjab revealed that in every 2 days, 3 farmers commit suicide due to rising indebtedness. The gravity of problems as well as its cause pointed out the most of the suicide victims were small and marginal farmers and labor households. Next. The incapability of farmers and agriculture laborers to pay off loans is major cause of suicides. The central government has provided several forms of assistance to the farmers, but the most of the farmers are at disadvantage of these assistance due to the lack of effectiveness of this scheme. So far, there is no improvement in the plight of the farmers and the suicides are continuous. Within the general concept, context of agrarian crisis, our paper makes an effort to estimate the extent and distribution of indebtedness among different categories of rural household according to source, rate of interest, and the purpose of indebtedness among the rural household of Bathinda district. An attempt has been made to identify economic factors influencing among the rural household of Bathinda district. Next, research methodology. There are 3 tehsils in Bathinda district. For the purpose of the study, 1 place selected from the each tehsil. This thus in all 3 villages have been selected for the district for the service. A representative proportional sample of the all household comparing farmer, agriculture labor, non-agriculture labor, artisans and other household have been taken up for the service. As a result, total 220 household selected for the service on random basis. Next. Result and discussion. The study revealed that 81.18% of the total rural households are under debt. The percentage is 83.96% for the farm household, 90.19% for the agriculture labor household, 81.25% for the non-agriculture labor household, 81.82% for the artisan household, and 45.45% for the other household. The average amount of loan per sampled household is ₹3,26,677 in rural area of Bathinda district. The average amount of loan per sampled household is the highest for the home household. Next. The average sampled household has taken 1,77,172 for the institutional agency, while 1,49,504 for the non-institutional agency. In case of institutional agency, the commercial banks are the main source of debt. Next table. An average simple household has taken 57.93% of the total debt from the institutional sources. Remaining 42.07% of the total debt has been taken from the non-institutional sources. This proportion share is 91.25 and 81.86% for the agriculture labor and non-agriculture labor households respectively. An average simple household has taken about 51% of the total debt from commercial banks. The other households and firm households have taken 85.72 and 55.15% respectively for the total debt from the commercial banks. An average rural household has acquired 21.35% of the total debt from the commission agent. The other sources come at the next rank, for which an average suburban rural household has obtained 10.64% of the total debt. The large farmers are another important source of non-institution debt, from which an average suburban rural household has taken about 6.19% of the total debt. This percentage is high as 75.31%, 43.1% and 43.93% respectively for the agricultural labor, non-agricultural labor and artisan household. About 6% of the total debt has been acquired from the cooperative societies, banks. Only the farm households have taken 6.67% of the total debt from these sources. The share of relative and friends in the debt, total debt is 1.5% of the average sample rural household. The above analysis clearly brings out the fact that firm and other household have taken debt mainly from the institutional agencies. The artisans, agricultural labor and non-agricultural labor household have taken debt mainly for the non-institutional agency. These households find it easy to get loans from private agencies, and they hesitate to take loans from institutional agency because of the time of consuming formalities, regulations and burdensome procedure of lack of collaborative assistance. And indebtedness according to the purpose of debt. The analysis shows that maximum amount of debt is availed by the rural household to purchase the firm imports. The average sample rural household occurs 98,109 for this purpose. The firm household spent the highest amount on the purchase of firm inputs. Next important purpose of debt is family maintenance expenditure. An average sampled household, rural household occurs 74,881 for the family maintenance expenditure. The agricultural labor, non-agricultural labor, artisan and other households spend the maximum amount for the family maintenance. Next is among the different purposes, the highest proportion goes to the purchase of firm inputs. About 30.03% of the total debt is spent on the purchase of firm inputs. The firm household spend the highest proportion of total debt on the purchase of firm inputs and mechanical equipment. An average sample rural household has taken 22.92% of the total debt for the family maintenance expenditure. This proportion is high as about 48%. For non-agricultural labor, 40% for other household, 36.46 for agricultural labor, and 21.0 for farm household respectively. An average sample rural household has taken 22.92% of the total debt for the family maintenance. An average sample rural household has taken 40.82% of the total debt for the expenditure on marriage and other social religious service. This proportion is high as 15.10% for the farm household, followed by the non-agricultural labor, agricultural labor, artisan and other household. Fourth main purpose of debt is education, which accounts for 14.79% of the total debt of an average sampled rural household. The farm household have taken the debt mainly the purchase of farm inputs. The agriculture, non-agriculture labor, artisan and other household have taken mainly for the family maintenance. The annual consumption expenditure of these categories of rural household for exceed their annual income. So to maintain the minimum level of consumption, they can resort to borrowing the mainly for the consumption purpose. Next table. An average sample rural household in rural area of Bathinda district have built the maximum amount of debt at the rate of interest ranging between the 15% to 21% per annum. The firm household and agricultural labor household have taken the highest amount at the rate of interest ranging 1% to 7%. The amount of non-agricultural household has taken the highest amount at the rate of interest above 29%. The artisan household have taken the highest amount of rate of interest ranging between 1% to 7%. The other household have taken the maximum amount at the rate of interest ranging from 8% to 14%. The analysis further explained that 41.60% of total debt of all categories have taken at the rate of interest ranging between the 15% to 21%. This proportion is highest for the firm household. Table number 7.
From statement mentioned in conclusion, sir, of the explanatory tables, these are not very visible from the slides.
Okay, sir.
You have the write-up, so you can read, but they can't.
Okay.
So you draw us the conclusions.
Okay, sir. And conclusion and policy implication. The above analysis shows that more than the 4/5 of the rural household in Bathinda district are under debt. The average amount of debt per household is highest for the farm household and the lowest for the all other household. The agricultural labor, non-agricultural labor and artisan household have taken debt mainly for non-institutional agency. Source wise, the agricultural labor, non-agricultural labor and artisan household have similarity in the pattern. For these household, major source of debt are the large farmer traders and commission agents. For the farm household, the major source of debt are commercial banks, cooperative banks and commission agents. These facts clearly bring out that even after 7 decades of independence, the agricultural labor, non-agricultural labor and artisan household are still in the clutch of the non-institutional agency, particularly large farmer and traders. The farm household have taken loan mainly for purchase of farm inputs. The agricultural labor, artisan and other have taken loans for the family maintenance expenses. The consumption expenditure exceeds the income of the rural household to maintain a minimum level of consumption to bridge the income consumption gap they have borrowed from the different sources. There is urgent need to take effective measure to overcome the problem of indebtedness. A system is required to develop where there should be no cost of borrowing except interest. The government should provide interest-free loans for to rural household. Proper information should be provided to the poor session about the institutional credit. There should be establishment of local public banks which provide loans at concessional rate. This will reduce the dependency of poor people on the non-institutional source and help them to attain loan at the low rate of interest. The government must be provide free and compulsory education. The government should be launch a program in order to provide free technical and vocational education to the children of the rural households so they may be able to establish their own venture. Agro-based industry must be set up in the rural households. Effective measures should be taken to increase income of the rural households by developing subsidiary occupations like dairy farming, poultry farming, beekeeping, etc. Minimum support price of agriculture product must be fixed at a reasonable level by taking into consideration cost of production and consumer prices. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So very nice presentation. So you have said that in Bathinda district there is more than 81%. But clear that the loan taking is depending on the farm size, then livelihood sources, family size, and purpose of loan you have mentioned. And you have also made some suggestions for the government that there should be MSP, there should be free education, there should be subsidiary education, self-procurement, and processing should be strengthened. Thank you very much for your nice presentation. So we come to the next presentation. So it is a
confusion idea. Can you differentiate?
And no need to highlight the methodology. So you just introduce your subject and then come to the conclusion.
Is it
So rather than